Hey guitarists, Devin here from Hope Community Church. We want to give you a quick video of some helpful tips for guitar tone and guitar pedals for worship music. So whether you play here at Hope or you play at another church, this is for you and I hope it's helpful. The first pedal that I want to talk about today are overdrives. Now, an overdrive pedal is a pedal that heightens the frequency of the signal going to the amp, and it gives it the sound of overdriven tubes, hence the name overdrive. But in worship music, we guitarists like using what are called transparent overdrives. And so whether you use a pod rig or you're all about the gear, no matter what, it's all about the tone that you get. So I wanted to show you the tone really quickly and what a transparent overdrive sounds like. A transparent overdrive is a pedal that, when engaged, it adds a little bit of grit and heightens some of the frequencies of the tone that you have already. Now, an overdrive that's not transparent is that when the pedal is engaged, it's enveloping your tone in just severe distortion and saturation and grit, which may have its times in music, except for most worship music, it's all about that nice, clean, transparent sound. So the pedal that we're using today for this demo is called the JHS Morning Glory. Now, what I love about this pedal is that it's affordable and it also represents a lower gain JTM 45 type tone, which is great for rhythm or for lead guitar, and it gives you a lot of headroom in the mix. So I'm gonna show you my signal clean and then I'm gonna engage the pedal and you'll hear exactly what I'm talking about. Here is my guitar clean. And here is my guitar with Morning Glory engaged. You see, it's only added a little bit of color and you could still hear my guitar and my amp. It hasn't saturated the tone to where it's indistinguishable, and it's just a really great sound to have, especially with worship music. The next pedal that we're going to talk about are delays. Now, obviously, we all know that worship music is covered with the delay effect. Now, what the delay is, it is a digital or an analog pedal that takes the signal that you're putting to the pedal and copying it. Very simple. I want to give you a brief demo of the type of delays that you'll be using primarily when playing the worship music that you'll be playing at church. For this demo, I'm going to be using a quieter dotted eighth delay, and I'll be playing the lead melody line from the chorus of Unstoppable God by Elevation Worship. So here is my signal clean. And here is the signal with the delay engaged. The delay isn't overwhelming, but it adds just enough feedback to where it's tasteful, and it's also exactly how Elevation plays it. All right, the next delay that I mentioned was the quarter delay, and this is also a delay used very often in worship music. And I'm gonna use a heavier quarter delay with the lead guitar line from the old Christian Stanfield song, Always. It really captures the quarter note delay well. So here is the signal without the delay. And here is the signal with the quarter note delay engaged. It almost makes it sound like there's two instruments playing, yet it's still tasteful, and it's also exactly how they play the song. All right, so the third and final effect we'll be covering in this video tutorial is the reverb effect. Now, this has been commonly used in studios for years, and essentially what it does is it takes a mono signal and widens it to give it a stereo feel. So when playing lead guitar, this is great to have because sometimes you're just playing single notes or just picking a few strings. So I'm going to show it to you using the lead guitar line from Sky Full of Stars by Coldplay. And it's a very simple lick, but they put a ton of reverb on it and it makes it sound absolutely beautiful. So I'm going to play it clean for you and then engage the effect and you'll hear the difference. All right, this is clean. And this is with reverb engaged. So as you can see, it very simply takes something that you're playing that might sound basic at first and widens it and makes it sound a lot bigger, and it makes it shimmer in the mix. So to finish off the video tutorial today, we're gonna take all three effects that we just spoke about and combine them together. Now with worship music, this is something that lead guitarists do very often, and you're gonna see how amazing it is when you take an overdrive, a delay, and a reverb and mix them up and play it at the same time. So I'm gonna turn on my transparent overdrive, my dotted eighth delay, and also the reverb that we just played, and you'll see how awesome it sounds. Thank you everybody for watching this video today. I hope it was helpful to you in your journey with learning guitar effects and guitar tone. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to email me at devinc@gethope.net. Have an awesome day.